Hi, my name is Nick Stowoviak, and me and Brooke, who is filming right now, are doing our British Cultural Studies video right now, and we are going to be interviewing international students that are coming to Kiel for the first time, or England for the first time, and we are going to ask them questions about what they thought about the different stereotypes of England and how they see them now.
Hi, my name is Bianca,
and I'm Laura.
We're both from Canada, and we came here on exchange, and we're going to talk to you about our ideas about England before we got here, and what they are now.
Yeah.
So, I didn't expect there to be so many different accents or like how they sound. I just assumed that since England was such a small country, everyone would kind of sound more like, have like the London accent. But as you go more north or more south, you can definitely hear a different sort of twang in their talk, in their speech. Well, I wasn't expecting there to be such a language barrier when I came here. I was like, oh, they speak English, we speak English. But there are definitely a lot of slang terms that took a while to get into my vocabulary. Especially in Stoke, where they call us duck or ducky or flower. And there's definitely more swear words that we've learned since being here. My favorite being Bellend.
Alrighty. Anything else? How is it now? Do you understand everything?
Oh yeah, yeah. As you get to know more like British people, it definitely you start to understand their language more and their slang terms. And I also find sometimes like the melody of how I speak is now sounding a little more British,
less harsh
too. And yeah.
Alright, thank you.
Bye.
Hey, what's up? Today, Sam, Candy, and I are about to break some boundaries about the UK and North America. Yes, we both speak English. Yes, we're both good looking. But there are some subtle differences, especially in conversation strategies.
So get ready.
Okay. So Sam, Candy will be playing North America, and I will be portraying the UK, specifically England. Go team. And yeah. All right. Stage number one.
So stage number one is hello or hey.
Aye! Boom. Stage number two.
Okay, see you later. Bye.
See you!
Stage number three. Hey, how are you?
You're right!
Of people when you first got here.
Oh, this is how they impersonate us. In Canada!
They make
in
fun
Canada.
Of us.
Oh my god! Oh my god! That's how they make us sound, yeah. Man.
Also, like, during the day, they're like really like low-key and quiet, but mm-hmm. at night, that's you see what they ask you, and they're just
that's when shit gets
crazy.
Mm-hmm.
Crazy.
Yeah, that's true.
Rage.
Rage cage. They ask you the jungle.
That's another thing. They go to the SU during the week instead of on the weekends, or is it home? We go on the weekends instead of during the week.
Yeah. Yeah, they complain about everything pretty much. Like constant. They moan a lot. They moan. They're grumpy.
Yeah.
They think that this is cold.
I think this is cold.
But beside all these things, England has been grand. British people are whack. Freaking dope. We love it. Come to Brazil! JK, come to England. And Spain. Bye!
Hi, I'm Bridget from California in the U.S.
I'm Allison from Indiana in the U.S.
And we're going to talk about British food types and what we thought about British food before we came here and what we think about it now.
Before I got here, I really thought that British food was going to be a lot like what I would think French food would be like. So very culinary, very fancy. And since being here, it's not as fancy as we originally thought.
More like pub food is really pop. And you guys eat a lot of sausage.
Yeah.
And your food is pretty bland. Okay. And you guys eat a lot less fruits and vegetables. Like, you guys are afraid of vegetables. Like, you call it a salad on your plate, but it's not really a salad. And like, iceberg lettuce, not a real salad. Chips are fries.
Yeah.
And crisps are chips.
Yep.
And biscuits are cookies and scones are biscuits. Wrong. All wrong.
Your food also doesn't like last as long as I feel like American food does. I feel like it gets bad really quickly. So we have fruit, it doesn't last as long here as it would maybe back at home, and I'm not really sure what that reason is, but it definitely does not last as long as in America.
I think maybe in America our food has more preservatives. More fake, so maybe it's good that your food doesn't last as long. That's a good thing.
Alright, anything else about British food?
What the fuck is salad cream?
Okay. You guys need to get some
salad cream. What is that? I don't like it. And you put vinegar on a lot of stuff.
Yeah.
I like that, but it is weird.
Maybe you put some more spices in your food to lighten it up a little bit.
You guys are afraid to eat with your hands. Like,
you're so proper all the time. You don't have to take it for
yeah, like, to... don't eat chips with a fork. Like, eat with your hands. Like, what? Like, I've seen people eat their burgers with a fork. Like, no.
Yeah. Well, some of your hands do it too.
Put your hands in there.
Pull apart and just, yeah.
But go that way. It's satisfying.
Alrighty. Anything else, guys? Good?
No.
Alright, bye.
Bringing you a comparison slash a segment on the differences between North America and the England of the UK. Now, censorship warning on this because we are going to break boundaries and break minds with how awesome this is. So just emotionally. Portraying the role of North America, which, yes, encompasses United States